so another new feature, and again, this one is really exciting, but this one is being released in a beta version. So again, for those of you who know environment, you know that we have the edit wall in place tool, which is pretty cool. And we released it on a beta version just because, you know, well, we had it and it's still not done, but our clients are really enjoying it. Plus their feedback really helps us improve the tool. So same goes about this new tool that we have over here in the terrain and site component panel. Go to the topography tools dropdown and you can find the long awaited Create Excavation tool. So what this tool is doing, let me just open that and open the show here. What this tool is actually doing is creating an excavation topography underneath selected elements such as walls, floors, other topographies, toposolids, etc. So basically, once you've finished your design, you can create your excavation plans again in a few clicks. I do have to say that depending on the size of the project that you want to use, this might take a while. So make sure to save your project before that. But again, this is our long-awaited tool and we're really happy to be able to release that. So what I'm going to do now, I would like to create an excavation that will connect with the existing topography over here. So let's say that's my house and that's what I want to create. I want to create a certain topography that will connect with the existing one. So that's what I chose here. Okay. And when I'm saying connect to existing, don't forget that you don't really have to have an existing phase topography. You can select any topography as your existing topography. And that's, you know, just because you may have other phases in your design, something temporary that you want to connect to. In any case, again, over here, there's a lot of flexibility. So I'm going to select all the elements. All right, let me start like that. I'm going to select all the elements that I want to relate to. So these are going to be the walls, this floor, this pathway. Let me filter them out. I want walls. I don't want the roofs. I want the floors. I do not need the second level over here. So I can really filter out what are the elements that will affect my excavation. Next, I'm going to choose connect to existing. And then it says, all right, specify existing topography. That's going to be my existing topography over here. Now, let's take a look at the diagram again. So the height offset, it's this one, it's A. I'm going to do it 50 centimeters. The side offset, let's make it 60. I don't know, whatever. It just depends on you. Enable sloped connection. So do you want to see these slopes or do you want it to be really straight like that? Okay, so my slope is going to be 45 degrees. It just depends what are the units of your file. If you have percentage, then you can use percentage. And if you have degrees, then that will work as well. And let me click on OK right now. Not save my file. And so basically, it will start to generate the excavation topography. It will be a different topography, even if I'm connecting to the existing one, just to allow you to preserve the existing topography. So again, it might take longer in bigger projects, if you have more complex surfaces, if you have more complex projects. So this is really the time, you know, if you're doing this command to go get yourself some coffee or have lunch and come back and have all your work done for you. Thomas here that's saying with Dynamo, it took me sometimes hour to do complex excavation. Yeah, so here it is. Close. I hope you will see improvement with this tool. So let's take a look at the results. I'm going to hide the original surface over here and I'm going to do a section box over here and just move it like that. So there it is. Very simple task that, you know, doing it manually would be such a big headache. But, you know, with a proper tool to do it, I think, again, for me, this is a game changer because this toposolid or topography, don't forget that it also allows you to get the cut and fill quantities.